no business in the house of God.
Amen.
We just put a title ministry on stuff and think that God got accepted because we calling it a ministry. And I'm trying to figure out, how does this stuff make people spiritual? There ain't no ministry just because that's what you call it. He said you put a difference between holy and unholy. Everything cannot be called holy because God is holy. Thank you, kind spirit. Everything ain't got no place in the house of God because everything ain't holy. And so he said, I'm not going to do everything for you. He said, you got to put a difference between the holy and the unholy. We said, God, if you don't want me to smoke this dope, then you flush it down the toilet. God said, no, that ain't the way it's worked. Now, if you want to live holy, you put a difference between the holy and the unholy. If you want to stop drinking that liquor, God's not going to pour it down the sink. He said, I gave you power when I gave you the Holy Ghost. You put the difference between holy and the unholy. I wish I could get about 37 of you to look at somebody and tell them, maybe I got some cleaning up to do. God, I got to go clean out some stuff because he expects for me to put the difference between the holy and the unholy. He said, and between unclean and clean. Hear what he says now. He says, if you sanctify yourself, then the very God of peace will sanctify you wholly, completely. If you sanctify yourself, then God said, what you cannot do for yourself, I'll come in and finish the job. But you got to do what you can do first.
Amen.
We expect God to do it all. And God said, you got to discipline yourself. You got to stay away from stuff that's not like God. You got to refrain, amen, from committing. You know what the psalmist said? He said, I don't even want to set no wicked thing before my eyes. And when you have done what you can do, then God said, I'll come in and I'll complete the work. I'll sanctify you completely. Family, one of the problems that we're having now is that there are not a lot of disciplined people in the body of Christ. We want it all. We don't want to just come all the way out because we like having fun. But one of the scariest scriptures, and I tell people this everywhere I go, one of the scariest scriptures I have ever read. Jesus makes two comparisons. He said, broad is the way that leads to destruction. And a whole lot of people going to find that way. But then he says something else. Now this is the part that scares me. He said, straight and narrow is the way that leads to salvation. Now that word straight don't mean without curves. It don't mean without corners. It don't mean a line. That's not what he means by straight. It's not S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T. It's S-T-R-A-I-T.
Yes, sir.
And that straight means difficult and tedious. Look at y'all and say, look here. We thought it just meant, oh, I'm going straight. No, that ain't what that means. He said, this is a difficult way. This is a tedious way. You know why? Because if any man come after me, he said, the first thing you gotta do is deny yourself. And a whole lot of folks don't want to do that. So he said, it's difficult. And then he says three words that I can't shake. He says, few there be. Did you hear the word? He says, listen to what he said. Out of all the people going to church. Because you know, you got churches that have five services on Sunday.
Lord, have mercy.
A friend of mine has a church that seats 5,000 just like mine. He has four services. He came and said, man, I preached to 20,000 people in person today. 20,000 people. And out of all those people, the Bible still says, few there be.
Yes.
Lord, have mercy.
More people going to church now than have ever gone in the history of the world. And Jesus still says,
few.
Only a few. That's scary. Yeah. And all these people shouting and all of many people speaking in some tongue, Jesus still says, you will be. That's on fire. So that means you got to discipline yourself to make sure that you're one of the few people.
Yes, Lord.
That's on fire. I love your family. I got to leave you. But Jesus, after he had given the disciples power, the Bible said he stepped up to heaven and two men stood by and said, why are you standing here again? Don't you know this same Jesus that you saw going up? He's coming again.